Okay, good evening to everybody. Here we are, Wednesday night. I don't need this on me. We're going to do Niggunim connected with the Parsha again. There's always something we can connect with the Parsha. Oh, Hashem. Let's see what when you get to Vayikra, Bamidbar, we'll see what we find then. But now it's easy. We're still with Yaakov Avinu for the last week. We have to do his Niggun also. Yaakov Avinu is blessing the tribes. Each one gets a different blessing because each one has its own way, its own unique personality and whatever for each tribe. And I want to do some Niggunim today that belong to many Hasiduyot. Either the same words with different melodies or the same melody, the way it's going between different Hasiduyot. Let's start with what? Let's start with a very famous Lecha Dodi. Let's go on with it. Start with that. Lecha Dodi Likrat Kala Benei Shabbat Nekam Bela Lecha Dodi Shabbat Nekam famous, very loved Niggun. It's a breast of Niggun. Even though there's different sources that maybe have come from much earlier than Breslov, it's not an original Breslov Niggun. And they probably took it from whatever different Hasiduyot. But it's a beautiful one. That's part of what I wanted to do today, is take this Niggun of Lecha Dodi and see melodies from all kinds of directions, all kinds different kehilot, different chassiduyot that are, it's sung in them. Let's take another Lecha Dodi, famous one. One of the most famous ones that people sing is actually Chabad Niggun, but I don't know if it's an original Chabad Niggun or not. Thank you. recognize it? Lecha dodi likrakala penei shabbat mekabela. Lecha dodi likrakala penei shabbat mekabela. Yom in asman tifosi beet hashe. I don't remember. I mix up between the Chabad and the way they sing it in Shul because. I know the words. That's the way it goes in Shul. Right, but in the Chabad, it ends up a little different, which is beautiful. That it has there's a difference. Now. Another interesting melody. I know just a part of the jig of our. Something like that, but I don't know it enough to sing with you, but you probably know it. We have some Mojits ones, very beautiful Mojits in Niggunim. From Mojits. There's another Mojits known one. See if I find which one is which. I think there's a Dolte Boshi famous by that. I'm going to get mixed up with that. I think this one is also Mojits. Just remember, I forgot to do a very interesting lechadodi in the Hebrew part of the class. So remind me, I have a very special lechadodi from Prague that I want to do with you. Let's do first. You know what? It might be older than the one I want to do now. Let's do the Prague nigun. So this lechadodi from Prague is very ancient. They used to sing it in the alt Neuschul in Prague, maybe even the time of the Maharal, of the Holy Maharal. And it was written in the, they had a diary, whatever they had there in the Pinkas, a little book of the Kihila, of the congregation, and they used to write things there, and they had the notes for this song written in the, in the, in the book. The book got lost in the Holocaust, but it was copied. I mean, it was written Tafkuf Tzadik Vav, which is 19. Wait a minute. Let me figure out. If Tafresh Tzadik Kuf Tzadresh Tafresh Tzadik Vav is 1939, so 100 years before that, 1896. In 1896, it was written in the book in the Kehila. It was copied just before the Holocaust. Somebody copied it, and the copy was left. So I'm going to try and play this very interesting Lecha Dodi from Prague. Lecha Dodi likat kala pnei shaham bekumela. Lecha Dodi likat kala pnei shaham. לא שומעים טוב?
שאלתי אם זה מוקלט.
עוד פעם?
אם זה מוקלט.
כן, זה מוקלט. אבל בואו נעשה עכשיו ונתחיל את הניגון.
איפה אפשר לקבל את ההקלטה?
בעזרת השם אחר כך. בערוץ של גל עיניי נשמתה זה יהיה. ואם תכתבי לי לטלפון שרשמתי קודם, אז תוכלי גם לקבל בפרטי. אוקיי. טלפון ש... טלפון. The Niggun from Prague, Lecha Dodi, Atik Yomin mi Prague. Lecha Dodi, Likrat Kala, Pnei Shaham Bekumela. Lecha Dodi, Likrat Kala, Pnei
Lecha Dodi, ancient one from Prague, from a time maybe of the Maharal himself. Now let's do another. למה באמצע שיעור את מפריעה עם שאלות? אז כתוב פה, את רואה בצ'אט? או שאת לא רואה את הצ'אט?
לא, לא כתוב.
אז אני אכתוב עוד פעם, אבל לא לדבר באמצע כשאני מנגנת, זה ממש לא מנומס.
טוב, סליחה.
הנה. רואה עכשיו? אוקיי, סורי. לפחות לחכות בין הניגונים. So I want to do another ancient Lecha Dodi from the Alter Rebbe. דרך אגב, שיעור בעברית ב-8 עד 9, בשמחה רבה לכל מי שמצטרפת, ובאנגלית מ-9 עד 10. So now we're in the English parts. In the Alter Rebbe, there's a Lecha Dodi that he wrote, which is over 250 years old, and they combine with another nigun of his, which is Likrat Kala, one of the chapters of Lecha Dodi, and if you do it the way I understand, you don't finish the way you started, so you start another key, and then you go on to another key, you can go all through all the keys. Let's start with, okay. Lecha Dodi, how does it start? The Alter Rebbe one. Okay. Stuff.
went through many keys. It's a beautiful melody by the Alter Rebbe, less known. Let's go to something faster and happier. Let's do another one from Breslov and Karlin, and who knows whatever Hasidiyot. They also sing it many times after the second part of Lechadodi, when they traditionally change a melody. Okay. Shabbat nekabela, toda, ba, ma, ma, na, na, na. See what else we have. Another one that's ended up in Chabad, which comes from another Hasidut. Very interesting. By Chabad, they took it for a nigun for the Rebbe's birthday. I don't remember which year, the year that this pasuk was in the chapter for the Rebbe's birthday, capital. Yifrach be'emav tzadik v'rof shalom ad bli areach. Somebody can look it up and tell us which chapter it is. In Sefer Niggunim, it's Niggun 311, and it's known as a Kozak, a Niggun of a Kozak, by Rabbi Israel of Mozhitz. Rabbi Israel of Mozhitz, that's his Niggun, and it ended up in Chabad. As a niggun, very much like a march. That's a different one. You probably know this one also. It's very famous. A lot of happy tunes today, Baruch Hashem. Let's do something a little less known. I think I did the other one that is probably Mojit. Let's do another one in Chabad, which is called the Chadodi from Lomje. Lomje le Chadodi. There was a town in Poland called Lomje. And it's in Sefer Niggunim also, it's 217, but I'm going to do it from the book from Rifkin, the Niggunim that he taught. It has many parts, it's beautiful, less known. From Lomje. Any other Lechadodi that you know that you would like me to do? That you remember? Any specific one? We'll go on. I think we did the ones I already wrote. So let's go to something, another interesting thing. We're talking about Yaakov Avinu. We said we should do his Niggun of Yaakov Avinu. Last time for this session, I think, because we're saying goodbye to Yaakov. So I tried to write something, I can't read. Okay, somebody's still looking for a phone number. And then, כתבתי מספר טלפון פה, או שזה היה לפני זה. Okay, that was long ago, so I guess she already got my number. Okay, so Yaakov Avinu's Niggun, we did it almost every week this winter. And the story is that the Rebbe Buchach has it in his book, Dat Kedushim, with a story of how it got around. We're not going to tell the long story now, just that Rabbi Yisrael Mirojin said on this Niggun that this Niggun, Yaakov Avinu took out the sheep to graze. And we have the notes written in this book, Dat Kedushim, and Rabbi Yisrael said about that. So the Rebbe Buchach says, how does he know? Because he has a spark of Yaakov Avinu. His name is Yisrael. We're going to think of Rabbi Yisrael Mirojin later. I hope if we have time. But let's do the Niggun of Yaakov Avinu. Niggun of Yaakov Avinu. Saying goodbye to Yaakov Avinu. Let's go to some Amar Hashem LeYaakov, Al Tira Avdi Yaakov. We're already talking about Yaakov. One of the most famous ones, and this melody is from Rabbi Israel of Mojitz that we mentioned before. Be singing with me. Oh, there's another one. There's so many of them that I don't know, but some of them that I can recall. One that is probably from Skulen. We didn't do the Skulen in the Hebrew part, let's do it in the English part. Amar Hashem LeYaakov Al Tira Al Tira Adi Yaakov Al Tira Bachar Hashem Ben Yaakov Al Tira Al Tira Adi Yaakov Al Tira Al Tira Adi Yaakov Al Tira And everything is on the same Al Tira Adi Yaakov Al Tira And I got it some I'm not sure that last part was a Skulen. I think it might have been written by the Bobaver Hasidim for the Skulen, or the other way, vice versa. I don't know, but it's somehow combined between them. Beautiful. There's one in Chabad also that they sing. Avram Fried had it in his recordings. Chabad one, even though they usually don't sing all the poems for Mitzvah Shabbos, but still, Hidgadu to the Chabad repertoire. There's a Melitzer one, if I can remember it right. In the Hebrew part, I did made a big salad between some melodies. I made a mishmash by them. Let's try and remember the Melitz. Not Moshitz, but Melitz. The Melitzer Rebbe wrote a lot of beautiful Niggunim. It's not such an old Hasidut, but still very beautiful. Does it go? No, this is the same one I did before. I don't know how it starts. Okay, let's go. It goes. Amar Hashem leYaakov, al tira beYaakov. Bachar Hashem parts. From Melitz, I got safely through this time. Toda Hashem. We don't have that much time, so let's do a few more things. We already did all kinds of Hasidiyot. Let's do something from Bells that I really love. It's not Amar Hashem LeYaakov, but it's a. Karibon Olam, beautiful. Thank you. beautiful bells, Niggun. Yiddish sang for Karibon. Interesting that by Slonim they sing something very similar. Fast one. Something like that. Very same Niggun in a different version. Got to Slonim. Let's do something that is combined between Chabad and Karlin, and maybe Chabad and Breslov. I didn't do it in the Hebrew part. Let's see if I can remember it. That we have it at Breslov and by Chabad and by some other Hasidiyot also. Yonah Matzav Manuach. I can't remember it now, but let's do two of the Chabad Karlin Niggunim. It's not a surprise because there was a person that wrote some chassid and wrote Niggunim for both Chabad and Karlin and some other chassidiyot, and he passed from one to the other, so he brought the Niggunim from one to the other. Might have been because of money that he didn't get paid enough, and one of them he went to the other, got to Chabad because he didn't pay him enough. But one of them is Niggun Pei Zayin in Sefer Niggunim, 87 in Sefer Niggunim. I want to do another one first, before that one. We'll go back to this one. Remember it? 126. Also written by Yankele Talechaner, the same chassid, 126. It's a heavier niggun, let's do it first. And then we'll go back to 87. In Karlin, they sing it for Maus Tzur. And the Karlini, they send me a recording. I can't do it exactly the way Karlini are doing, but it's very square, very, goes to a very steady pace. And the singing from Maus Tzur. The last part, I think I remember the Karlini go like this. In Chabad, it's again, na 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 na. In general, in Chabad, they have more knetches, more like different. Let's take something that they sing by so many people. Everybody sings it like this. Had a hint for the Chabad. The way it's written in Chabad, different quinetches. So the Karlina says, why in Chabad it's so much nicer? It has a different saying. So this is the same Niggun that they sing in Chabad and in Karlin. In Karlin it's a Maus Tzur. I'll do it in a different key. Let's keep this key. Thank you. So we did this one first because it's a little heavier. Let's go to the other one also by the Rabbi Yankel Telechaner. There's many of in Chabad that he wrote. Most of them we don't even know that he wrote. This one we know. They sing it in Breslav and maybe also in Kalin. I don't know who else, but they sing it in other Hasidiyot as Litaneg v'Tanugim, Barburim u'Slav v'Dagim, one of the poems for Shabbat. In Breslav they have only two parts. That's in Breslav, but in Chabad it goes like this and it has a third part that they don't have there. Another Niggun in Chabad and Kalin. Even the famous Niggun and Sing and Pesach, the Isha Amda, is also in Kalin. So we don't know. Even the Niggun Mirostov, the Sing in Kalin, the Sing in Toldot Aaron or Satmar, and all kinds of Hasidiyot. The Sing, many of the Niggunim go around between so many Hasidiyot. It's such a beautiful mix and collection of achdos, of singing, so many nigunim, the same ones. We need Mashiach. It's time. Let's do a Sephardic song. Sephardic. I promised a niggun from Rabbi Israel Mirojin. Interesting, they sing the same melody was taken to be in a, like a folk song version for the Rory Krale Benimbat. Thank you. actually, it's the melody from the Rabbi Yisrael of Rojin. Let's do a bob of Nigun, which fits with our times and our prayers and with bringing Mashiach. Becha Hashem Chasiti Alevo Shel Olam is a bob of Nigun. Was taken into Chabad to sing also a kippetel for the Rebbe. Hashem chasiti ahalle bo shale olam vecha Hashem chasiti ahalle bo shale olam vecha Hashem chasiti ahalle bo shale olam vecha Hashem chasiti ahalle bo olam vecha Hashem chasiti ahalle bo shale olam So let's pray for the Gula.
Do we have to wait? We want Mashiach now. We don't want to wait. The melody is from his, the words is Chabad. And Matai, do we have to wait? We want Mashiach now. We don't want to wait. Mashiach now, we don't want to wait. And Matai, do we have to wait? We want Mashiach now, we don't want to wait.
Well, there's so many Niggunim we didn't do today, there's so many Hasidiyot we didn't touch, but Hashem sees the unity of the beautiful, beautiful different styles in Am Yisrael. And that's it. It's time for Mashiach. We have to bring Mashiach. So hopefully we'll see you in Beit HaMikdash next week. If not, we'll see you here in the Zoom. And have a wonderful week.